Oh, you know what day it is? A great day to remind you that hormonal birth control is poisoning you and Twitter is still up and running despite thousands of Twitter employees quitting to protest Elon Musk.
How will I ever survive?
I'm Alex Clark, this is Poplitics, the first ever daily conservative pop culture show. Thumbs up, subscribe to support us. Today we're getting into Tim Allen being attacked by the woke mob over what they're calling a problematic joke in his new scripted holiday show, The Santa Clauses, on Disney+. Maren Morris piles on the attacks for Candace Cameron Bure after she defended traditional marriage. The original Steve from Blue's Clues, remember him? He's talking about why he really left the show all those years ago, and I'll answer questions submitted by you for Pop Quiz.
Then let the games begin.
You're not gonna believe the joke Tim Allen said in his new series that has the mob demanding an apology. According to the New York Post, Tim Allen was slammed Thursday by woke Twitter users after saying Merry Christmas is suddenly problematic in his brand new Disney Plus show, The Santa Clauses. The so-called controversial scene depicts Tim Allen's character being asked if something was bothering him, to which he responds that saying Merry Christmas to all has suddenly become problematic, and he's sad about that. Well, the woke mob is now accusing Disney of all people, Disney, of pandering to conservatives to make a quick buck.
Sorry, I shouldn't laugh at that.
Let's just pretend the mob is right. This line was written to pander to conservatives. That would mean we get one bone thrown to us after how many years of putting up with hidden leftism in their content. If Disney really was throwing us a bone, and I doubt it was, it's the equivalent of crumbs, actually scraps. Meanwhile, everyone else gets to watch movies and TV that constantly affirms them.
Deal with it.
Maren Morris was quick to pile on Candace Cameron Bure after she said she's in favor of content featuring traditional marriages in movies. Maren wrote, "Make DJ gay again," under a post shared by social media personality Matt Bernstein that slammed Candace Cameron Bure, according to Page Six. So this Matt Bernstein guy wrote, "You went decades without ever having to see an LGBTQ character on screen. Now we're in one out of five movies. Sorry if this disturbs you. Sending thoughts and prayers."
Oh, boo-hoo. Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
Again, for the leeches in the back, Candace said she's glad to work for a company that will only show traditional marriages between men and women in their movies because she is a Christian!
She's not a Christian!
It's her right to make that content. It's not like she's imposing her views on Hallmark. She's literally removing herself. Maren Morris is just so desperate to become some sort of icon to the gays. She must not realize that spot is already taken.
Who is the queen of gays? Okay, I'm gonna get in trouble for this one because a lot of people will disagree with me. I know some will say Madonna. I'm gonna say, for me personally, Taylor Swift. I am a Swiftie till the day I die. I love that blonde woman with my entire heart.
I swear this has been discussed before, but sometimes people do interviews or articles come out and I'm like, I swear, didn't I discuss this on Poplitics before? Or maybe I'm just having deja vu.
Deja vu is usually a glitch in the matrix. It happens when they change something.
In a new interview, Steve Burns, who is the guy who played the original Steve on Blue's Clues that millennials grew up with, explained to Variety why he suddenly left the show in 2002, causing millions of kids to be forced to watch an imposter Steve.
We just got a letter. Wonder who it's from.
Suck my a-
He said, "I didn't know it yet, but I was the happiest depressed person in North America. I was struggling with severe clinical depression the whole time I was on that show. It was my job to be utterly and completely full of joy and wonder at all times, and that became impossible. I was always able to dig and find something that felt authentic to me that was good enough to be on the show, but after years and years of going to the well without replenishing it, there was a cost." He went on to say, "My strategy had been, hey, you got a great thing going, so just fight it. Turns out, you don't fight depression, you collect it." And that once he left Blue's Clues, there was a long period of healing. Steve Burns is doing press right now because Paramount Plus is coming out with a Blue's Clues movie and he's in it. I was thinking about which kid show ending hurt the most for me, and I think it was Rugrats. I'm not sure I ever got over that.
A Mecca baby's gonna do what a Mecca baby's gonna do.
There is a link in the Poplitics Instagram bio where you can submit questions for me to answer anytime, and I might answer yours on Mondays. This is what we call Pop Quiz. Tara from Florida wants to know, what do you plan to wear to the Taylor tour? I'm assuming you're going to be costumey, fancy dress. Well, Tara, if I even get to go after Ticketmaster Geddon, you know, I always try to dress up as Taylor lyrics or on theme with the album. For the 1989 tour, I dressed up as Taylor in the Blank Space music video. And then for the Rep tour, I did this snaky outfit. So I've been listening closely to lyrics on Midnights, and I'll probably try to interpret some into a costume if I even get to go.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Connor from Indiana asked, have you done any international travel? And if so, what are your favorite places? If not, what are some places on your bucket list? Actually, I've only ever been to Cabo and Anguilla, and I discussed where I would like to go travel to on the vlog we posted Friday on YouTube, where I get lunch and I talk about living together before marriage, and then I go on tangents about a bunch of other stuff, including travel.
I hope everybody likes the hotel.
Julie from Oregon wrote in, how do you feel about girlfriends that buy gifts for each other? I've had gal pals in the past that want to buy birthday and Christmas gifts, and I hate this. They act like it's the sweet gesture, but now I feel obligated to reciprocate, and I already have a husband, his family, my family. I don't want to have to spend even more time shopping for you. I know exactly what you mean. I think as adults, if you send just a card or you bake something homemade, that is completely acceptable. I know for me, I'm making Taylor Swift's famous chai cookies for a party that I'm going to, and I'm not bringing any other gifts.
Presents, I suppose.
Rachel from Texas asked, Emma Chamberlain, overrated or style queen? Now, a few months ago, I believe I said I didn't understand her or her popularity, and now I am completely obsessed with her. Style queen, advice queen, personality queen. She's also one of the most beautiful people I've ever seen. I love unique beauty, and sometimes when she's vlogging with no makeup, I'm just like, dude, she is still so pretty. And then when she is full glam for events, you're just like blown away. Although I did try to buy a sweater vest the other day that was very Emma Chamberlain inspired. And a guy I've been casually talking to, I sent him a picture on text. I was like, what do you think? Should I get this? And he was like, trying too hard to be Harry Styles. So, you know, I'm not sure that I can pull off Emma looks.
I never would have believed you were 3 years ago. You told me I'd be here writing this song. But here I am.
Annie from Washington wrote, where have you been getting style inspo from lately? Okay, Arielle Sharnes, always, Emma Chamberlain, Hunter Primo, Rachel Love, and Katie Kleinfelter. If you have a burning question for me, burning, and the heart desires burning, and the break of fire, don't forget that you can submit those through the link in the Poplitics bio. My emotional interview with Victoria Robinson on how men and women can heal and forgive themselves after abortion is available anywhere you get your podcasts. Subscribe to The Spillover, and if that interview touched you, please leave a 5-star review for us. Tomorrow will be the last episode of Poplitics for the week due to the holiday. And remember, tomorrow night at 9 p.m. Pacific, midnight Eastern, you're already getting this week's episode of The Spillover early. That way you can listen to it as you travel or even watch it on the Poplitics YouTube channel after Thanksgiving dinner with the whole family. Please thumbs up this episode. Subscribe to Poplitics on YouTube if you haven't. Why do you think Tim Allen's joke was so offensive to the left? Comment below. Don't forget to watch Friday's vlog with me discussing living together before marriage. It's like my most favorite content we've made in a while. I'll see you right here tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark, and this is Poplitics.